to the first live return of the MHS Music Banquet. Last year was to have been returned from a several year hiatus. We were happy to have produced a virtual banquet, made rounds for our seniors to deliver gifts and honors last year, but we are so thrilled that we can produce a live award ceremony this year and have all of you present. We are so lucky to have Dennis Jocelyn and the event broadcasting students to make this a top-notch production for those of you who can't be here this evening. Tonight we recognize and honor the accomplishments of all music students, especially our seniors, and look forward to the 21-22 school year with the announcement of next year's officers. Ms. Goucher will inform us all of the music lettering process.
Lettering in a music ensemble means that a student went above and beyond what was expected of every band and choir student. This means attending extra events, performing in more ensembles, taking on leadership roles, taking private lessons, auditioning for extra groups, being a leader in Matamida music ensembles, and representing Matamida in other music ensembles like church, colleges, Twin Cities youth orchestras and choirs, etc. The students that have lettered did more than what was expected of a typical band, choir, A student. This year had its added challenges in lettering in that there weren't as many events as usual to allow for earning points. This makes it extra exceptional for those that letter because they truly went above and beyond. I'll start with pep band letters. Pep band was very limited this year in that we only had 5 events total, including one that's this coming Friday. If students participated in 4 or 5 of the events, they earned a letter. If this is the first letter received at Matamida High School, the student will receive the M letter that can be used on a letter jacket or however the student would like. And they will also receive a certificate, such as this. If this is not their first letter, the student will just receive the varsity letter certificate. If I announce your name, please come to the stage and stand in a socially distanced line behind me to receive your awards. And you can come up as you hear your name. It's also going to go up on the screen in a minute. Congratulations to the following 36 students who lettered during the strange 2020-2021 pep band season. Our first time Matamida letter award winners in pep band, or in any Matamida, I think, was Ben Brock, Ethan Fisher, Angus McChesney, Elizabeth McChesney, Olivia Madsen, Ramsey Morell, and Maddie Typor. An additional letter award winner, again, as you hear your name, feel, come on up to the stage. Additional letter award winners. And additional letter award winners are Will Anderson, Helen Atkins, Matthew Bennett, Zoe Barrier, Claire Brings, Sarah Brings, Will Christensen, Michael Kanzenius, Hannah Coy, Sam Dahl, Daniel Gabriel, Razzie Gantris, Alicia Geezer, Marnie Geezer. You don't have to come to the stage if you don't want.
audience this year to honor a letter. If you're here, please come to the stage once your name is called and stand behind me. Earning their first Mommy Night letters are 9th grade students Cicely Evans and Alexander Puberty, 11th grade students McKenna Buckley, Cassie Casper, and Claire Nelson, and 12th grade students Hannah Rose Bruce. Also earning letters are 10th grade students Natalie Peekig, 11th grade students Jordan Rollinger and Claire Whitland, and 12th grade students Sonia Blake, Ash Carricker, Anya Concourt, Annika Leiner, Stella Pearson, and John Swift.
Achievement.
Betty Tegelhoff Flute Piccolo. Congratulations to these wonderful band musicians.
Thank you. drag someone into choir.
Oh, yeah.
Dominic Chichito, most likely to become a superhero.
Yeah.
Chris White, coolest musical taste. Isabel Zelch, most outgoing.
Alicia.
Most likely to be reading a book in Band Award.
Pepin instruments to hockey games. He builds full-on fire bells for curtains. Like, I'm just so impressed with everything he does. So, Andrew is our percussion mom, and he is going to be passing the title off, so you better think fast, Andrew.
Mom is an obvious choice, and we just had a little conference there between me, Sam, and Grant, and the next percussion mom will be Peter Olson.
I have the honor of being this year's low brass king and passing that down to the next generation, and typically I would be physically passing down a Burger King crown with paper euphoniums taped around the side of it, but I don't have it with me, so I will be metaphorically passing down the crown and physically passing down the crown at a later juncture. So tonight I'm going to pass down the very, very prestigious title of Low Brass King to Michael Kinzini. They are role model, cheerleader, leader, etc. All MHS choir students have the opportunity to vote for all seniors for this honor. The following was said of the student being awarded this honor tonight. Over the past 4 years, this person has been a figure of leadership and dedication. Not only have they put in countless hours to help the choir program grow, they have fostered a community in the choirs at MHS where everyone feels welcome and accepted. They never fail to bring the fun and make everyone's day better with their luminous smile and laugh. The program would not be what it is today without them. This person has been an inspiration to me ever since I met them in sixth grade. They are such a hardworking and passionate individual who has dedicated so much time and energy to the choir program and making sure everyone is accepted and loved, uplifted by the people around them. I'm honored to have had an amazing year working with them side by side with the other officers, and I know they will continue to be an inspiration within music as time goes forward. Thank you for an amazing last 2 years and believing in me and so many others. This person is always hardworking and dedicates so much of their time to choir. They are enthusiastic and always ready to work hard and create music. From telling people about their mind to always trying their best in choir. This person is one of the most amazing and dedicated people I've gotten to know. They are welcoming and kind to everyone, as well as being super passionate about building the theater and music programs. They have contributed so much to these programs, they would not be in the same, they would not be the same without their care and dedication to helping them grow. I'm so proud to present the 2021 winner of the Outstanding Senior Choir Member Award to Zala Pearson.
Now of Century College, in White Bear Lake, where he served for nearly three decades as conductor, professor, music department chair, and resident composer until his retirement in 1997. Soon thereafter, a commission from Bloomington Jefferson High School in Bloomington resulted in Zdechlik's most famous work, Chorale and Shaker Dance, which premiered at the Music Educators National Conference in 1972. Zdechlik claimed to have guest conducted the piece over 500 times in his career. He died in May of 2020, shortly after his 83rd birthday. Because he was a true pillar in Minnesota bands, I decided shortly after his death that I would start this award in his honor. Each band senior made a video that was shared with all of the MHS bands, and all 9 through 12th grade students voted for up to 3 seniors who they thought demonstrated commitment to band and exemplifying what it means to be a great band student. They were reminded it wasn't a popularity contest or even about musicianship. It was really all about the person. This is an outstanding senior class with 21 amazing musicians, people, and it ended up in a dead heat tie between 2 people for the award. Winner number 1, students said about her. She has been such a fun and outgoing member of the band for as long as I can remember. Her work ethic is unmatched, and she faced all the difficulties of a COVID year with confidence, never failing to provide fun activities or interact with the band as a great leader. She's an incredibly hardworking, determined student who never fails to go above and beyond what is expected of her. Throughout her time in band, she has contributed so much through her work on the leadership team, has consistently invested in all those around her, and she shaped our program into what it is today. She will be greatly missed. She's always been a huge mentor to me, from pep talks in car rides to pep band or pit orchestra whenever I was nervous, to offering helpful advice for my endeavors. She has always been there for me. I voted for her because she always puts others before herself. Her presence will be incredibly missed next year. She really embodies what band is all about. She works very hard to keep this band running, but she's always enthusiastic about it. I've never seen her without a smile on her face. Winner number 2, students said about him, he has time and time again showed thorough commitment to the band program, as well as trying his best to make band something to look forward to for his peers. Having him in the band has been nothing but a positive experience. I voted for him because he's always been helpful and supportive to everyone in the band. He also has a good attitude and awesome hair. He is a very dedicated musician and is always helpful and knowledgeable about music, and was a great part of the band community. Being present in life is important, but actions is what truly matters. He is great about communicating with all bands on what BLT has discussed. The band will lose a great player and liaison. Congratulations to Claire Brings and Grant Tyler.
Choir was added at MHS during the 2015 to 2016 school year. This award is given to a student who may not garner all the votes of the students, but has great vocal skills and has worked hard during their career as an MHS chorister. The student being honored this evening has worked so hard over the last 4 years to improve their vocal ability and musical skills. They have been an integral part of our choral community and have been supportive of every student involved. During their career, they were a great mentor to our students with different learning needs, and they always knew how to needle me, and I have the tiara to prove it. This year's Director's Award in Choir goes to John Swift.
Phenomenal skill dazzled audiences around the world. Lucille Armstrong, his wife in later years, described his love for people as follows. Louis's greatest personality traits were humility and generosity. He just loved people, and he always tried to understand them too. He was compassionate, generous, and understanding with everyone. He was loved not only for his style, but as a person as well. The Louis Armstrong Jazz Award was inaugurated in 1974 with the consent of his widow shortly after this great jazz artist died in 1971. It honors the outstanding senior jazz musician at each high school. To preserve the integrity of the award, schools are only allowed to give out one per year. This year, the award is presented to the senior who loves jazz with all of who he is. He's an incredible jazz musician and improviser. He often takes the lead with younger musicians and his fellow peers to help them grow in their jazz knowledge and comfort and love. And is someone, like Louis Armstrong, compassionate and loved, not only for his style, but as a person. Samuel Clifton.
They've been a leader in many different capacities, always working hard to support all involved in the program, learning the music for every program by heart, and has been a true model of vocal technique and work ethic. The student always gives their all in what they are involved in and will do anything asked of them. The senior has been an all-star in a class of all-star choir students. Congratulations, Sonny Blake.
Great dedication and commitment by some of the most talented young musicians in Minnesota. All of the young musicians meet again in February to perform at Orchestra Hall as part of the Minnesota Music Educators Midwinter Clinic. Unfortunately, none of this was true this year. But our students participated in several weekends of virtual rehearsals and then ultimately recorded their parts, with their concerts actually being premiered this week. Matamida is very proud of All-State Symphonic Band member Christina Hildebrandt, All-State Soprano Alto Choir member Claire Nelson, and All-State Jazz member Matthew Bennett. We have received these certificates for you, and we currently have plaques being made for you that we'll have for you next week or the week after. So please come on up here if you're here. I know, I think Matthew and Claire are both here. Come on up.
Representatives Sonia Blake and Claire Winland, Concert Choir Secretary John Scripp, Belvoir Secretary Isabella Fontaine, Dolce Harmonia Secretary Cicely Evans, and Recruitment Officers Delaney Mellon and Anna Swanson. To run for an officer position, students complete a choir leadership form and write an essay on what position they would like to run for and what strengths they could bring to that position. All current choir students then voted on the students who completed the form. Our slate of officers for the 2021-22 school year are ZPAP representatives Clay Winland and Lauren Gomez, Belvoir Secretary, yes. Our Belvoir Secretary and Concert Choir Secretaries are to be determined because we are now having an audition process to get into those groups and we don't know who will be in them yet. That process will start after our Hops concert. Reporter historian, Jay Craig. Librarian, Michaela Martin. Vice President, Cicely Evans. And next year we will have co-presidents. They will be Jordan Rollinger and Natalie Putin.
Before I announce next year's officers for band, I want to thank the 16 incredible students who served on the band leadership team this past school year. President Claire Brings, Vice President Alicia Geezer, ZWE Secretary Helen Atkins, ZWE Librarian Carly Packinen, ZWO Secretary Joe Wald, ZWO Librarian Sydney Plum, ZG Secretary Samuel Kaltman, ZG Librarian Caleb Hilton, ZCB Secretary Ishna Didwania, ZCB Librarian Terry Shifsky, Mott Band Liaison Grant Tiber, Historian Hannah Coy, Assistant Historians Greta Leiner and Zoe Redker, and ZPAP Reps Peter Olson and Daniel Gabriel. You did incredible things for your band program in a very challenging year, and we are so thankful for all you did and continue to do to advance the Mott Bands to new heights. And now, I'm proud to announce the 2021-22 band leadership team who will get us through the next challenges and bring hope to their fellow Mott Band family. Every student that applied for a position would have served the band beautifully. But choices ultimately had to be made based on essays written, votes of current band members, conversations with this year's band president, responses to further email questions, the need for different personalities and friendship groups, and different grade levels, and demonstration of leadership in the past school year. Thank you to all that applied, and even if you don't get a position, your leadership will still be looked to and valued in the coming school year. Instead of a mock band liaison this year, I am adding two outreach officers who will take charge of the freshman mentorship program and help bridge the gap between the middle school band and the high school band. In addition, similar to choir, instead of one president, I decided to have co-presidents, who will also serve as the ZPAP reps this year because they have the pulse on the band more than anybody. And in talking with current leadership team members, we realized it would be also beneficial to add a pep band librarian who only works on music during pep band season and also helps take attendance at pep band events. The 2021-2022 band leadership team, I am proud to announce, outreach officers Daniel Gabriel and Greta Leiter. Thank you.
Another turning point, a fork stuck in the road. Time grabs you by the wrist, directs you where to go. So make the best of this test and don't ask why. It's not a question but a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. So take the photographs and still frames in your mind, hanging on a shelf in good health and good time. Tattoos and memories and dead skin on trial. For what it's worth, it was worth all the while. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. Unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life.
Alicia Geezer, Hunter Hansen, Ash Carricker, Samuel
your skulls at graduation, a card, and your favorite snack or treat. Once I announce your name, please come to stage, and please hold your applause until all seniors are on stage. Lauren Anderson, Celine Barreto, Blue Perry, Maya Bolea, Hannah Rose Gruenstrup, Faith Christensen, Sam Crichton, Jane Dean, Ava Ingebrigtsen, Haley Finnis, Sonia Glade, Taylor Hansen, Ash Carricker, Ani Funkworth, Annika Liner, Zala Pearson, Milo Pierre Lewis, Madison Sheep, John Scripp, Santa Smithson, Annika Swanson, Dominic Cotito, Grace White, and Isabel Zell. Are interested in volunteering within the organization, please reach out to one of the directors and we will steer you in the right direction. Tomorrow we have an informational meeting about our 2022 spring break music trip to Southern California. We ask that parents be present on this virtual meeting. The Google Meet link has been sent via email or newsletter for choir. Please email Ms. Goucher or myself if you need the link or recording of the meeting. On Monday, May 24th, we will have our annual Choir Pops concert. Our theme this year is based on the book The Giving Tree by Shel Silverstein. We'll hold the concert in the Commons at 7 p.m. this year. Senior families are invited to attend in person, and SCC will be live streaming the event on television. Our final concert of the year will be the band concert on Monday, June 7th in the Chautauqua Fine Arts Center. The theme this year is A Childhood Remembered. Thank you for attending.
And also senior families are...
Thank you for attending tonight's celebration.